back on The Brew, consulting fortune tellers has become a New Year tradition for many Filipinos. From lucky signs and colors to developments in career and love life, Pinoys go to astrologers to get a glimpse into the future. But are these psychics really all-knowing? Let's watch this.
It's that time of the year again, the time to look at stars and signs and listen to the Sirius predictions.
The lucky number today is 9. The lucky color is midnight blue.
But before we gaze at the crystal ball for 2011, let's see if the psychics got the year of the tiger right. The late Jojo Acuin was right about star couple Judy Ann Santos and Ryan Agoncillo. Acuin, known as the Nostradamus of Asia, correctly predicted that Judy Ann will get pregnant in 2010. The queen of teleseries gave birth to baby boy Lucho in October. But Acuin's prediction for superstar Noro Honor did not come true. He said Ate Gai will regain her place in Philippine cinema and have a successful comeback. But the so-called golden voice lost her voice this year after undergoing a cosmetic surgery in Japan.
Hindi niyo lang alam kung gaano po sakit sa isang performer, lalo na po sa akin, na yung boses po ay hindi naman pinag-aralan ko eh. Binigay sa akin ng Diyos. At yung boses ko na yan ang pinuhunan ko para maiangat ko ang pamilya ko sa kahirapan.
It's not just Acuin who had the wrong reading of the star's stars. Psychic Maricel Gaskel foresaw Piolo Pascual changing channels. Although he was rumored to join another network, Piolo is still a Kapamilya. Gaskel was right though about the queen of all media. True to her prediction, Chris Aquino did not have the best of both worlds in 2010. The actress continues to have a successful career, but struggled with her marriage. In August, Chris filed for the annulment of her marriage with James Yap.
It must have been love, but it's over now. It must have been good, but I lost it somehow.
Fortune tellers also gave their fearless forecasts about politics. The psychic, known as Stargazer, said a respected political figure will pass away in 2010 because of heart failure. In January, then Press Secretary Serge Rimonde died after suffering a heart attack. Feng Shui expert Suzette Arandela meanwhile predicted that Noynoy Aquino and Ma Rojas will be the winning tandem in the May elections. But it was only Aquino who emerged victorious. Even Madame Auring had her own hits and misses, as she made predictions about President Aquino's love life. The fortune teller correctly saw that Aquino will not tie the knot in 2010. But she failed to predict his breakup with Valenzuela counselor Shalani Soledad.
At the present time, I think I'm just recovering also from a recent engagement, and there are just too many things. No?
Accurate or not, fortune tellers continue to be popular as Filipinos seek out their vision for 2011. But a look back at their predictions for 2010 reminds us that there is more to the future than what the crystal ball and the cards hold. In show business, politics, or daily life, it's best to heed the wise words of Zenaida Seva.
Hindi hawak ng mga bituin ang ating kapalaran. Gabay lamang sila. Mayroon tayong free will. Gamitin natin ito.
I don't think...
Well, what are you sneaking about? I mean, I don't want, you know, I don't want to comment. I mean, I'm just so tired also of this annual thing where the networks have no stories to do, say they'll go to psychics and they have these really ridiculous, corny
predictions. But viewers, they look for stories like these.
I mean, natutuwa. It's just that there's nothing more to be said. We know that, you know, that they're good for a laugh or two, but nobody really pays any, you know, puts too much stake.
2010 was good for everyone, except that we have losses and gains and etc. For 2011, my fearless forecast is Nadia will stick to the gym for 365 days, and Twink will be very prudent.
And you will drink gallons and gallons of water.
And I will drink a lot of water.
Good. Anyway, let's end the year with a Big thank you to our viewers, guests, and to Philippine stars Erwin Romulo. In his column this month, Erwin included The Brew in the list of shows he considers good TV. Erwin says, girls talking, whoever would have thought that would be compelling television? But it sure is. Thank you, Erwin, for that rave review. We are naming you a fellow Bruja.
Okay, send us your own reviews on the show. Tweet us using the hashtag Bruja, B-R-E-W-H-A, or post a comment on the ANC 24/7 Facebook page.
And that's your brew of the hottest developments in politics and pop culture.
For 2010.
Yeah. Join us again in 2011 for another serving of opinion, insights, and fun only here on
The Brew.
The Brew would like to thank Loft Details Furnishings.